Hi friends, welcome to my channel Interesting Engineering.
Today in our discussion we are going to discuss about electrodynamometer type wattmeter. So in our previous video we have already discussed about electrodynamometer type instruments. So as we all know, wattmeter is nothing but an instrument meant for measuring the power developed in both AC as well as DC circuits. So these instruments operate based on the electrodynamometer type instruments. So here this is the arrangement of an electrodynamometer type wattmeter, and this instrument also operates based on the principle of Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction. And here this instrument consists of five main parts. One is the fixed coil arrangement, and the second part is the moving coil arrangement. Then we have a control arrangement, damping arrangement and point and scale arrangement. So first we shall discuss about its principle. So as I said earlier, it operates on the principle of Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction, which means whenever we place a current carrying conductor in between a magnetic field, that develops a force which makes the pointer to operate. So the pointer indication will be the representation of the parameter that is measured. So here this is the moving coil arrangement, and both these fixed coil as well as this moving coil is made of copper coils. So this moving coil arrangement is placed in between the fixed coil arrangement. So the fixed coil is divided into two equal halves, and the moving coil is placed in between these two fixed coils. So here the current or the voltage is passed through this fixed coil, which makes it to act as an electromagnet. That is, when we pass current through these fixed coil arrangement, there develops some sort of magnetic effect. So when we place this moving coil arrangement in between this magnetic field, the moving coil arrangement is provided with a moving system. So when this moving coil is placed in the electromagnetic field, there develops a force on this moving system. So this force makes this pointer to deflect. So this deflection will be the representation of the parameter that we are measuring here. So here we are measuring power. So this indication is calibrated in terms of power. So here we are measuring power by means of the movement of this pointer. So this pointer is being placed over this moving coil. When the moving coil is placed in the fields of magnetic field developed by this electromagnet, that develops a force which makes this pointer to deflect over the scale, and the scale representation is calibrated in terms of power. So as we all know, power is nothing but P is equal to V into I, and this power is measured in terms of watts. Watts is nothing but the unit of power, and power is equal to voltage into current. So here we are providing input supply voltage. So based on this supply voltage, there occurs current flow through this fixed coil as well as the moving coil, and due to the magnetic field developed by this fixed coil, the moving system over this moving coil will be changing its position. So here also there flows current both in fixed coil as well as moving coil. Due to the current flow through this fixed coil, there develops a magnetic field, and here in this moving coil arrangement also there flows current. So this current into this input voltage will be measured by means of this pointer indication on the scale arrangement. Here we have the scale as it's a mirror based scale. So to avoid the parallax error, the pointer, the scale is placed over a mirror, and this pointer is a knife edge pointer. So these fixed and moving coil are made of copper coils. So here there is a one more difference in this fixed coil and moving coil arrangement. So this fixed coil is connected in series with the load, so it carries the load current. That's why it's also called the current coil. The fixed coil is also called the current coil since it is connected in series with the load and it carries the current, it carries the load current, so it's called the current coil. And the moving coil is otherwise called the pressure coil. The moving coil is also called the pressure coil and it is connected in parallel with the supply voltage. So here we have two coil arrangements. One is the fixed coil arrangement and the other one is the moving coil arrangement. The fixed coil is connected in series with the load and it carries the current to the load, so it's called the current coil. And here we have a moving coil. That moving coil is connected in parallel with the supply voltage and hence it's called the pressure coil or potential coil. Then we have control arrangement. Control, here we make use of spring control. We all know the pointer will be deflecting based on the magnetic field developed by these two fixed coil. So the pointer movement has to be stopped at one stage, so it has to be controlled. So to have a control arrangement, we place a spring at the bottom of this pointer. The spring arrangement will be placed at the bottom of this moving coil. So at the bottom of this knife edge pointer, there is a presence of a spring arrangement which provides a controlling torque. And then we need one more torque for any instrument to operate. There needs three different torques: deflecting torque, control torque and damping torque. So the deflecting torque is developed by means of the current through these two fixed coil, that is the electromagnet. Due to the interaction of the electromagnet, due to the interaction of moving coil in the electromagnet, there develops a force which is nothing but the deflecting torque. And the controlling torque is developed by means of spring arrangement provided at the bottom of this point arrangement, and that spring provides a force, opposing force to that of the deflecting force. So that makes the pointer to come to a steady position. So that torque is called the controlling torque. And we make use of air friction damping. Here we go for air friction damping to provide a damping to the movement of this pointer arrangement. That is, when the pointer is provided with a force which is nothing but the deflecting force, it starts moving from its normal position. So due to its movement, the pointer will be placed over the scale arrangement. So that deflecting torque will be opposed by the spring arrangement, so that produces a controlling torque. Even then the pointer will be deflecting back and forth, so that deflection will have to be reduced to zero by means of damping arrangement. So for that purpose we go for air friction damping. So the five main parts in an electrodynamometer, wattmeter, or fixed coil arrangement: moving coil arrangement, control arrangement, damping arrangement and pointer and scale arrangement. So here the fixed coil is connected in series with the load, so it's called the current coil. Moving coil is connected in parallel with the supply voltage, so it's called the pressure coil. Then we make use of a spring arrangement to provide opposing force to that of the deflecting force. Then the damping, here we make use of air friction damping to stop the movement of the pointer, to stop the oscillation of the pointer. Then we have a pointer, knife edge pointer, and mirror based scale for representing the power developed in this circuit. So these are all the five main parts present in a electrodynamometer wattmeter. And regarding its operation, I said earlier, it is based on the Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction. That is, there develops a control torque to the movement of this pointer by means of the interaction of this moving coil system with that of the magnetic field developed by this fixed coil arrangement. So due to the interaction of these two forces, there develops a force that could move the pointer to a particular position. So that moment is nothing but the deflecting torque. So this deflecting torque has to be opposed by the by some sort of force so that it can come to a steady position. So for that purpose, we provide a spring arrangement at the bottom of this moving system. So this produces a opposing force. Suppose if the deflecting torque force is in this direction, the spring develops a force in the opposite direction. So whenever these two forces gets balanced, the pointer will come to a steady position. Even then, the pointer will be somewhat oscillating over the scale. So that oscillation is reduced by means of this air friction damping. So this is the operation of this wattmeter. So in this wattmeter, we provide supply voltage. Based on this voltage, there flows current through these two coils. So that current induces magnetic field here. So when this moving system is placed in this magnetic field, there develops a deflecting torque. So that deflecting torque, when it is balanced by the controlling torque, then the pointer remains in a steady position. So the pointer's oscillation will be reduced to zero by means of this air friction damping. So at that position, the pointer indication will be the representation of power, and it is power is measured in terms of watts. So this is the operation of electrodynamometer type wattmeter. So regarding its operation, now we shall derive the torque equation for this operation of this wattmeter. So as we all know, the power equation is for a DC circuit will be power represented by P, and it is equal to V into I. That is, V is nothing but the voltage and I is nothing but the current through the coils. So power is equal to V into I, P is equal to V into I. V is voltage, I is current. And when it is used in the AC circuits, there develops a phase lag due to the presence of either inductance or capacitance in the coils. So at that instance, the power in the AC circuits will be represented by P is equal to VI cos phi, where phi is nothing but the phase angle between the phase difference. So VI cos phi is the equation for power calculation in an AC circuit. So now let's derive the torque equation for the electrodynamometer type wattmeter. So this wattmeter measures the instantaneous torque. So Ti is equal to I1 I2 dm by d theta. That is, the instantaneous torque developed in this wattmeter is due to the currents I1 and I2, and since here there involves two different coils, there develops mutual inductance. So Ti is equal to I1 I2 dm by d theta. And the input voltage what we are applying, so the instantaneous voltage will be denoted by V is equal to root 2 V sin omega t. So the current in pressure coil, so here we have two coils, So one is the current coil and the other one is the pressure coil. So pressure coil is nothing but the moving coil. Current coil is nothing but the fixed coil. So the current in pressure coil is given by IP. IP is nothing but current in pressure coil is equal to V by RP, where V is nothing but the voltage through the pressure coil and RP is the resistance of the pressure coil. So it is equal to V is nothing but Vm sin omega t. So here we have V equation, so root 2 V sin omega t. So instead of V, I am replacing by root 2 V sin omega t. So the current through the pressure coil is denoted by root 2 V by RP sin omega t. Since here there involves V by RP, V by R is nothing but current. So we can replace this by IP. So I am writing it as root 2 IP sin omega t. Suppose if the current lags the voltage by an angle phi, that is the current, since here there involves two coils, and if there is an involvement of inductance or capacitance, there occurs either lead or lag of voltage. So here if we are considering lagging current, suppose if the current lags voltage by an angle phi, this current equation changes as IP is equal to root 2 I sin of omega t minus phi. Since here we are deriving for lagging current, we are writing it as minus phi, that is root 2 I sin of omega t minus phi. So here we need to calculate the deflecting torque equation. So I am going to derive this now. So we have derived the equation for IP. So in our TI equation, we have I1 I2 dm by d theta. So instead of I2, I am going to replace this current equation. So root 2 IP sin omega t into root 2 I sin of omega t minus phi dm by d theta. This root 2 I sin omega t is current through the current coil, and this root 2 I sin of omega t minus phi is current through the pressure coil. So this is I1. So this is I1 and this is I2. I1, I2, instead of I1 and I2, I am replacing it by root 2 IP sin omega t. Instead of I2, I am replacing it by root 2 I sin of omega t minus phi dm by d theta. So as we all know, root 2 into root 2 will be 2. So here there is constants. So I am writing it as 2 IP, IP bringing here, then I, then sin omega t sin of omega t minus phi dm by d theta. Then here, since this is sin a into sin b form, this is of the form sin a sin b, so I am writing it as ip I. Here sin a into sin b, that will be cos of a plus b minus cos a minus b. So I am writing it as cos a plus b will be let me write it as sin a into sin b will be equal to cos of a minus b minus cos of a plus b. So this formula, I am making use of it here. So this is sin a sin b. So sin a into sin b will be cos of a minus b, 1 by 2 into, so here 1 by 2 into cos of a minus b. A and b, a here is omega t, b is omega t minus phi. So a minus b will be cos phi. So ip into I cos phi minus a plus b will be omega t plus omega t minus phi. So it is 2 omega t minus phi. So I am writing it as ipi cos phi minus cos of 2 omega t minus phi dm by d theta. So 2 gets cancelled out. So this 2 doesn't comes over here. So ipi cos phi minus cos 2 omega t minus phi dm by d theta. So this is the torque equation, instantaneous torque equation.
Now we need the torque for a time period of 0 to t. So I am going to integrate it. So it is td will be equal to 1 by t integration 0 to t ti d of omega t. So now I am going to integrate this equation with respect to omega t. So 1 by t, ti is nothing but ipi cos phi minus cos of 2 omega t minus phi dm by d theta into d of omega t. So when we integrate, we have it as ipi cos phi dm by d theta. So here instead of ip, I am writing it as v by rp I cos phi dm by d theta. So this is the deflecting torque equation. So we have derived the equation for deflecting torque, and it is equal to vi by rp cos phi dm by d theta. So as I said earlier, the deflecting torque, once it is balanced by the controlling torque, the pointer will come to a steady position. As we all know, Tc is nothing but the control torque equation, and it will be equal to k into theta, where k is the string stiffness and theta is the deflection of the pointer. So Tc is equal to k into theta. When these two gets balanced, the pointer will come to a steady position. So I am balancing these two equations. So it is k theta is equal to vi by rp cos phi dm by d theta. So we need the value of theta. So I am bringing this k to the other side. So theta is equal to vi by k into rp cos phi dm by d theta. So here this vi, instead of 1 by k into rp, that I am replacing it by a single constant k1 vi cos phi dm by d theta. So here this vi is nothing but vi cos phi is nothing but the power equation. So this vi by cos phi is nothing but the equation for power. So theta is equal to p k1 dm by d theta. So our deflection will be proportional to power, since k1 dm by d theta, these are all constants. So that theta will be directly proportional to power in a electrodynamometer wattmeter instrument. So this is our equation. So in the first case, we are deriving the equation for instantaneous torque. Then we are integrating that instantaneous torque equation with respect to omega t. So when we integrate, we get it as ipi cos phi dm by d theta. And once this deflecting torque is balanced by controlling torque, the pointer will come to a steady position. So I am equating these two. So finally we get it as theta is equal to p k1 dm by d theta. So theta will be proportional to power in the case of electrodynamometer wattmeter. So this is about the construction and working of a electrodynamometer wattmeter. So we shall see about the errors and how to rectify errors in these instrument in our next video. So for more videos, keep watching. Please subscribe and share. Thanks for watching.